Good afternoon, or morning, or evening, depending on where you're watching from. I'm Rippy Longstocking. I'm here with Sissy Splasek. And you're watching the 2019 Wftda International Playoffs live from Winston-Salem, North Carolina, brought to you by the Greensboro Roller Derby and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association.
Tonight we're going to see Bay Area taking on Lomme. It's from Bay Area,
right.
In California, of course. And they are the tournament number 8 seed. And they'll be taking on Lomme from Lille in France. Mm-hmm. They are coming in at the number 11 seed for this tournament.
And now we'll start a little team rostering. I'm going to introduce Lomme to you. That would be number 2, Honey Boo Boo. Number 21, Harley Quinn. Number 220, Garce Attack. 23, Sniffy Guffer. 237, Minimoise. 2936, The Bad Lebowski. 312, Tetrice. Sorry. That's my bad, Dectatrice. 380, Pinky Bruiser. 42, Tajanader. 712, Princess Bombass. 973, Kamos.
And of course, for Bay Area Derby, we have number 128, The Boon Villain. Number 13, Stephanie Maney. Number 1395, Leg Cite. Number 1979, Neuralize Her. Number 20, Ava Menace. Number 27, Red Card. Number 404, Big Perm. Number 42, Esteemed Bun Bun. Number 422, Beaver Mainsbridge. Number 538, Kate Silver. Number 666, Grim Reba. And number 888, Brawlin' Angel.
Lovely. So let's tell you about who's going to be making sure we're doing everything correctly, and that's our officials for today. We have Geo Knitter, Apron, Silken Tofu, Melody Mayhem, Ricochet, Neutron Scar, W.E.B. Destroys, Pat Sweeney, The Doctor, Coconuts Chanel, and on skates will be Bass Invader, Pika, Will Ryder, Doesn't Matter, Recordian, Shotgun Mike, Jane Goodcall, and Queen Kictoria.
And if you're a nerd at Derby, you can check us out at www.wftda.com and learn all the rules of the game and more. And if you have questions for us, we're also on Twitter, and you can find us using the handle at @WFTDALive and the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA. You can ask us questions during the show. We'll try to answer some of the best ones and the funniest ones. And in the chat throughout the game and broadcast and beyond.
Yes. So let's tell you a little bit about how we got to this place today. So for taking a look at our bracket, Lomme came in and played Helsinki in our game number 3. That was Friday, yesterday. And took a loss there. And then we have Bay Area, which played Atlanta Roller Derby and took a loss at that game. And so now we have this consolation game here between these two teams. So, again, both of them have played once before yesterday.
Yeah, so, you know, they had hard games yesterday.
They really
but
did.
They've gotten to rest since then.
Mm-hmm.
You know, doing a game on Friday and a game on Saturday is totally fine.
Yes.
But you do have to, coming in as losing both those games,
yes.
You sort of have to figure out not more really how to rest your body, but how do you get your head back in it?
Right. And I think we'll see these teams come out with a little bit of energy. Watching them play yesterday, I feel like they're going to have a little energy as we start.
You're going to notice that Lomme is there in the red with like a light green, sort of a minty
yes.
green accent and white numbers. And then Bay Area in black and sparkly gold.
And that rolling whistle tells us that we're getting ready to get started. It's Kamos, yes, wearing the star for Lomme, and Leg Cite wearing the star for Bay Area. Both jammers looking for opposite lanes, but it's Kamos that comes out first as lead jammer for Lomme.
Yeah, you're seeing Lomme set up with that nice tripod in the front. And Bay, once again, we saw this all yesterday in almost a flat four wall in the back to catch, letting mm-hmm. the jammer make the decision on where she wants to hit that wall.
Right, and we talked about presenting your back in that situation as well. Now, Legs also has made it out of the pack, eligible to put points on the board. So let's see, and there's the call-off.
This game brought to you by Quick in the Rydell family. When you need to roll quick, think quick. Quick Bearings, where precision meets performance. You can see that lovely replay there. Oh, just holding the inside line. Not an extra little turn there, but just a bonus turn from the jammer.
I am a fan of the replay. I'm a fan. So that's Garth Attack taking on Kate Silver off the line. Kate Silver gets bumped into the infield. Garth Attack looking for a way through the front of that pack. Oh, and now Garth Attack gets pushed into the infield and Kate Silver to the outfield. So we're going to move the pack all the way around back to the far straight. Nope, now we're almost at turn two.
You know, sometimes you just want to see what the other side looks like. Yeah. And if you can't get there going forward, you got to go backwards.
You know, and stretching out the pack doesn't hurt your jammer, but now everybody was able to totally reform, and we have two really miraculous tripods out there. I guess a tripod and one here at the front with Bay Area. And Kate Silver gets pushed into the infield. And that was the Boone Villain, right? Getting a penalty
yes.
there. We'll head to the penalty box.
It's like Boone Villain picked up a direction penalty.
That is not hard to believe, considering the back was doing it so far. So Kate Silver here almost gets out of the pack several times, but the defense of Lomme just reforms constantly in front. And now we have a penalty. And finally, a lead jammer is called. That's Kate Silver for Bay Area.
And it looks like that was the Bad Lebowski picking up that multiplayer.
So Minimize coming in now with the star. Real quick star pass there. Minimize not quite able to. Oh! Sorry for the sound effects. You didn't see that on your camera, but we just had a little fall. No problem.
In the replay there, you're seeing Kate Silver with a gentle jump right over. Oh, and such brilliant work to the outside. And then you're seeing that really strong tripod from Lomme. But yeah, right in there, you could see those arms just start to link as Kate smartly pushed against them.
So Honey Boo Boo is wearing the star for Lomme, but it is Ava Menace that's out of the pack first for Bay Area. Quick work of the pack there. Nice job. Now, there has been a quick star pass here for Lomme. And it was so fast that I didn't have time to tell you it was Princess Bombass that got the star, but Ava calls that off quickly. So our score is 4-3 in favor of Bay Area.
And we saw that.
I just lied.
There you can see Ava breaking out of the pack. That's a good angle. Bay Area with 8, Lomme with 3.
Yeah.
And 25, little under 26 minutes left to go in this first half.
So that is Beaver Mansbridge taking the star for Bay Area and Camos. Back on the line for Lomme.
I wonder if we'll see that again today. Yesterday in the game, Bay Area against Atlanta, we saw almost every time there was a star pass, there was such an immediate conservative call-off.
Mm-hmm.
Just getting those few points and calling it off and getting out of there. And we saw that again with that last gym. So it'll be interesting to see if that continues.
That's Camos out of the pack first. Picks up lead jammer there for Lomme.
Steamed Bun Bun with a twirl backwards.
So Beaver is working hard against the two one remaining blocker for Lomme and just can't seem to shake her. And, oh, that was a penalty picked up by the Lomme blocker there. So that leaves Beaver out of the pack. That was 312, Tetrice.
Looks like that was a forearm protected trees. Yeah, not going to say little. That was me qualifying. Some contact there.
Yes.
Officials, internets at home. This game brought to you by Adam Skates. Have you tried the Adam Savant wheels? See what you've been missing. AdamSkates.com.
So Lomme with a few penalties here. We start with two blockers in the box. That's Leg Cite back on the line for Bay Area and Garth Attack wearing the star for Lomme. And legs out of the pack very quickly, and we see the star off the head of Garsatak, and a penalty will be assessed to Garsatak. So this will be a power jam for Bay Area in control of the track.
And it looks like that was a cut track. Waiting to have that confirmed.
Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. Garce returns.
Garce JKs and is back on and a pretty clean right up the middle.
And so, yeah, I think Garce was able to sort of take advantage of some of that confusion that was happening there and just went right through the pack. And now on the inside, Garce picks up an additional four. There's already four on the board for Bay Area and legs. And Lexi Tate calling it with the extra four. So it'll be eight total for Bay Area, four for Lomme.
It does look like that cut was waved off by the outside pack ref. So obviously OPR is having a much better advantage than anyone else.
I mean,
inches away from the action. And
yes,
moving at the same speed.
It really does take all those pairs of eyes to see all that stuff happening.
We have a timeout for Bay Area. With a time to regroup. I'd like to talk about Derby Without Borders. You can check out derbywithoutborders.org and see how you can help support the growth of roller derby around the world. Remember to bring your donations to the 2019 playoffs and champs. We are smashing the barriers of accessibility to roller derby by providing leagues with coaching, support, and equipment.
So we will wait for everyone to return to the track.
Quick update, we are at Bay Area 16. Lomme is at 11, so we have a very close game.
Mm-hmm.
And 23 minutes left to go in this first period.
So we do have an empty penalty box as we start this next jam. Kate Silver will take on Honey Boo Boo. Both jammers getting hung up right in front of the jam line. This pack is not moving at all. We do have a penalty assessed for Bay Area.
And Bay Area, once again, doing that three wall, but where the skater in front has the legs in front. And so as soon as you hit one of those back two skaters, it only makes them stronger.
Yes, and you can see Honey Boo Boo trying to step through.
I would have said, get out of there. But at this point, Honey is very, very in there.
Yeah, so helmet cover off of Honey Boo Boo. Kate Silver, meanwhile, picking up lead jammer. I was just really fascinated with that kind of blocking that was happening there. Really smart. Kate Silver, through the pack, picks up four, takes a look at the bench. They say, keep going.
Deck to trees with a forearm penalty. And we just had Brawlin' Angel also enter the penalty box.
So now Kate Silver is getting stuck in a pack of defenders also. We're just seeing the defense here, I'll say, at this tournament so far has been fairly...
We've had pretty low-scoring games.
Yeah,
so you are seeing such defense-heavy, but also with very precise offense. I feel like offense in the last few years, you know, at first it was don't bother with it,
mm-hmm.
and then it went to okay, let's play very exaggerated, very, you know, very obvious offense, and now it is such quick little smart moves.
Mm-hmm. So Kate Silver finally out of the pack there, does pick up an additional four. Honey Boo Boo is going to try to put a shoulder on Kate Silver, but Kate Silver withstands the impact. And Honey Boo Boo out of the pack now on the initial, eligible for scoring. So Kate Silver is going to call that off.
Bay Area with 25, Lomme with 11, 21 minutes left to go in this half. This game, of course, brought to you by Antic Skates. The all-new Antic Jet Carbon is packed with features at a great price. Antic Jet Carbon, featherweight performance.
Ava Minnis taking the star for Bay Area. That's Kamos back on the line for Lomme. Oh, little pile up right there around. Oh, and it will be a forearm assessed for Kamos. So that leaves a power jam and an opportunity to pick up lead for Ava Minnis, and that is what She does.
Ava with a beautiful pirouette on the inside line. You see a lot of times people will want to turn away from the track or away from the boundary and give their back to that, to the players. And she went the other direction entirely.
Yes. Through the pack again for an additional four.
Stephanie Maney with that offensive hit.
Yep.
Just, and right there, just a tap, just enough to be distracting. I mean, obviously, a hit from Stephanie Maney is not just a tap.
It's not going to be a tap.
I get it, Internet. But, like, just that quick move.
Right. Opened up the lane right away. So now Lomme is got a shoulder on Ava, but it looks like we have penalties just being assessed left and right. And a jammer penalty will again go to Commerce.
Yeah, it looks like sent right back to the box.
And that's Tajanator also in the box. So we have the jammer and the pivot for Lomme in the box. An incredible run there by Ava Menes. 12 on the board total.
Yeah, and that's the largest single jam we've had so far.
I mean.
Yeah, you can see Ava right there to the inside and then
just...
just saw that sight line, positioned, gave the Packer back, and ran right for that straight line.
It's a good choice by Bay Area Derby to field leg Cite for this jam. And this is the thing that we saw yesterday. We'll run back and stretch out the pack, keep those blockers. But they are, Lomme is down a blocker. Bay Area has a full complement of skaters. So legs able to pick up lead really quickly there. On the far apex, and then now with two blockers, and those blockers are getting stretched out, and yep, there we have a out of play. So legs gets through. That's four on the board.
But 30 seconds off of that penalty.
Right.
With being down a blocker, although we're seeing with two Lomme blockers sent to the penalty box at the end of that. So you're seeing some of that pressure of being down and having your jammer in the box where everyone kind of ups their gameplay a little.
Yeah.
And you're going to see that reflect in penalties.
So legs, it can give and as well as take hits and does so there. Busts through the remaining blockers, picks up an additional four. So 12 on the board so far for legs Cite. Now everybody has cleared the box. We've got all bodies on the track. And legs are on the outside.
Well, and Kay Moss has not put the helmet cover back on or passed it.
Nope.
So went to the box, went back to the box, just working on that mental game, as a jammer of what happens, when you immediately go right back to the box. You have to kind of reset your thinking. And then coming out and still being in this place of, is it going to be a pass? Is it going to be put back on?
So I want you to keep your eye on Tajanator. It's number 42 in the red, trying to get back to her jammer to get the star pass, but Bay Area keeps bumping Tajanator, and there we finally have the star pass. And I don't know whether that was a legal one or what was the question there.
The pass seemed good. I really like what Tajanator just did there. Knowing that the opposing jammer is coming up, knowing you probably don't have time to run away and, put it on and make points, but waited, just held it in hand, waited with the pack. Oh, there, yeah, huge hit from Lake Cite there on Tajanator. Mm-hmm. Held it and waited so that if she needed to play D, she could before putting it back on.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a timeout for Lomme.
So an incredible jam there by legs, 18 points total. So just like there was a little bit of confusion there and the star pass, but I'm really interested to watch the video archive of this game to watch Bay Area has totally got an eye on that pivot to make sure the pivot and the jammer can't connect.
Yeah, absolutely. It was a very, very smart play to separate that. Mm-hmm. You can see in your replay, pivot Tajanator looking, moving back, and right there was the hand grab. But Lake Cite, as the jammer, was doing the block to separate them. This game brought to you by S1 Helmets. Durable, functional, stable, the S1 Pro Knee Pads are built for roller derby. S1helmets.com. You can see the penalty board there. Got, you know, a few here and there. Nothing really severe. 9 total for Lomme, 7 total for Bay Area at this point. Really nothing that's a big standout. Probably the thing affecting most is that we have 4 jammer penalties for Lomme.
Yeah, that may be the story here of the first part of this half anyway. Speaking of which, we only have 16 minutes, 24 seconds left in the first half. So that is Beaver Mansbridge, of course, wearing the star for Bay Area, and Garza Tech with the star for Lomme. Both jammers again in the swarm of bodies.
Bay Area doing what it can to set up in back, always.
Yeah, and
feels
lost
like very consistent play.
2 blockers to the box for Bay Area, so they're not able. And as soon as someone gets out, another one goes in, and that gives just enough room for Garza Tech to pick up lead jammer for Lomme.
It looks like esteemed Bun Bun sent recently. Big Perm exiting the box.
Oh, there we go. A nice move there, Garza Tech. Through the pack, 4-4 or so. Lomme putting some points on the board.
Steph Maney exiting the penalty box and then immediately joining that front blocker to form such a tight two.
And you can almost see Garza Tech realize, oh no, she just came out of the box. But prepared for that hit and got through again for an additional 4. So 8 so far on the board for Lomme. And again, that's Garza Attack through the pack again. So 12 so far for Lomme.
Looks like Stephanie Maney picked up a direction in that last little scrum.
Oh, and Garza Attack through again for 4. Meanwhile, so Beaver has passed the star. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to neglect that for Bay Area. And I think we have, is that red card?
Yeah, it looks
yes,
like
that's
red card.
Yeah, with the star now. Now giving chase to Garza Tech.
Yeah, and we saw Brawlin Angel take the star quite a few times yesterday for Bay Area. Mm-hmm. I don't believe we saw red card. But
not as many times. Okay. If maybe 1 or 2. Yeah, I don't remember exactly, but that was a 20-point jam by Garza Tech.
That was a huge jam for Lomme. You can see in your replay there that hit to the outside, number 42, steamed Bun Bun. Oh, looks like we have an official review.
We do have an official
review.
Bay
Area.
We will hear from our head official here in just a minute. Or our head referee, I should say, our skating official.
Game brought to you by Adam Skates. Adam Skates, hashtag roll your way. And if you want to follow along with all the live game updates and matchups, you can do that at stats.wftda.com. You can forecast the game results.
Bay Area's first half official review. Bay Area has requested that a forearm penalty be issued to the Lomme jammer during their initial pass.
All right.
Interesting. Okay. During the initial pass. So.
Which would have changed quite a lot of that jam.
Yes, that was a 20-point jam.
Yeah, if you're going to ask for it, that's.
I mean, you know, go for it.
To do it on.
So, of course, we will hear from our officials as soon as they are decided.
If you want to be a part of the Champs crew, VIP tickets are already sold out, but there are still 3-day passes available for the 2019 International WFTDA Championships in Montreal, November 15 through 17, and don't miss your chance to join us in person for this monumental event. You can get all your tickets at wftda.com/tickets.
So we will hear.
After review, the officials have confirmed that there was no forearm penalty to be issued. and Bay Area will not retain their first half review.
Okay. All right. So there is the update. That will not be issued, which is certainly good news for Lomme.
Yeah, very impactful jam. Mm-hmm. So
yeah,
you would hope to hold on to those points.
So Kate Silver taking on Honey Boo Boo off the line here. Oh, sorry for the sound effects. Don't mean to.
You know, we're also just watching roller derby. So if you're making that sound at home, we're going to be making it here.
So Kate Silver able to grab that inside line, just really take advantage of the bodies moving outward. Picks up lead jammer for Bay Area, comes into the pack, recognizes the Honey Boo Boo is also out of the pack and coming up quickly, and so decides to call it off for 2 points.
Yeah, very calm and composed. Mm-hmm. Kate Silver had time to look up, make eye contact with the bench, see that there was still a little bit of time, and then call it off.
And call it. So we are at 57-31 in favor of Bay Area, about 13 minutes and 30 seconds left on the clock in the first half.
In that replay, you saw that huge hit on Honey Boo Boo, and mm-hmm. just to the left side of your screen, you saw a very calm Kate Silver rushing past.
So Eva Menace with the star taking on Camus. And so Camus is out of the pack as lead. I mean, sorry, is out of the pack first, but it's not lead. I apologize. And Eva Menace gets out of the pack and calls it immediately, which is the move you want to make.
So Camus passed a skater out of bounds, but it mm-hmm. was legal.
Mm-hmm.
So, unfortunately, not picking up the lead. But, yeah, there was that realization you saw when Ava realized that
oh,
was, in fact, was, in fact, lead and could get out of there.
So that is Garza Tack on the line for Lomme. And Leg Cite wearing the star for Bay Area. And so a little pile up here on the inside line, but everybody stays in bounds miraculously. Legs pushing against the front of the pack. Finding a little purchase, but not able to shake everybody. And now spins around. The last blocker gets out as lead for Bay Area.
A lot of action in the back of the pack.
Yes.
Looks like that was 237 Minimois getting a forearm penalty for Lomme.
Garza Tack has this helmet cover in hand, but the pack is so stretched out, there is not a lot of hope. Oh, I'm sorry, her pivot is in the...
Yeah, it was very unlucky, very unlucky timing to pick up that forearm right.
Really not going to get the pivot at this point. Yes, that is correct.
At least not from this direction.
Yes.
But the plus side is when the pivot comes out of the penalty box,
yes.
it's perfect position to grab that hat.
And you can see Garth looking behind. Now, meanwhile, Leg Cite is like, I'm going to put up another 4 points. There's the successful star pass.
Yeah, and that was like handing the baton.
Mm-hmm.
Like that was perfect from behind, reach back.
And that was Minimois who had the star for Lomme. And Lomme unable to put points on the board. That got around 10 points for Bay Area.
You see the replay there.
Lovely.
With that beautiful
just
pass.
Nice.
Yeah, really just like a baton. Like we're doing the lovely. Relay out here.
It was lovely.
Yeah, it's not a great feeling when you take the star off and realize your pivot's in the box, but it's not that bad when you're at the back pack.
Right. You could see them setting. You could see their eye contact setting it up. So that is Honey Boo Boo back on the line and Kate Silver. Kate Silver's kind of running a little interference there with Honey Boo Boo. And Kate Silver picks up a cut track, I believe. I'm looking to double check that, but a penalty nonetheless. We'll head to the penalty box. Now, lead is still available. Power jam for Lomme. And there, Honey Boo Boo picks up lead.
I'm seeing a forearm penalty for Kate
okay.
Silver.
I guess with the arms up, it looked like a cut.
Yeah.
The forearm could get a look at. Oh, no. And now we have a back block assessed to Honey Boo Boo. Kate Silver out of the box, of course, and now engaging.
And Kate Silver with that offensive call to her pack,
mm-hmm.
pointing which direction the offensive push came to match that, so she'd go the other way.
Lots of stuff happening there. Kate Silver picks up, this time for sure, a cut track. And I believe Honey Boo Boo was standing when Kate Silver received that penalty. And so this will put her, you know, 20 seconds or more. So Honey Boo Boo, oh, does a little slide from the left to the right, gets out of the pack, picks up 4 points. Because Honey Boo Boo had the initial before the penalty call there. Little friendly fire there. It gets a little hit from Harley Quinn, but is back on the track immediately.
Looks like Big Perm picked up a four-arm penalty on that.
Now Kate Silver released from the box, getting recycled back a little bit by Princess Bombass. Another four put on the board by Honey Boo Boo. And that jam ticks down to a close.
So just in the last few jams, we've ticked up our penalties a little bit. Mm-hmm. So you're seeing some intensity there, and you're seeing people getting a little bit tired. Lomme with 12, where they had 9 just a few jams ago. You see the replay there. So approaches the back.
Yeah. So yep. Honey Boo Boo gets that penalty right at the very end. So we will start with a power start for Bay Area. Ava Menace with a star.
Bay Area running a drill out there.
Mm-hmm. Hanging back to try to stretch out the pack for their jammer. And Ava's able to pick up lead jammer status. Honey Boo Boo still in the penalty box. Now Lomme is down one blocker as well.
Ava Menace at 100% lead jammer percentage this game so far.
Good choice of jammer for that power start. Now Honey Boo Boo has been released from the box. Oh, nice work there by Sniffy Giffer. Oh, wow. We're seeing a lot of red shirts in and out of the penalty box. Now the pivot is in the penalty box for Lomme, and Ava Menace around the outside picks up an additional 4.
And Honey Boo Boo with that helmet cover in hand, so we may see a repeat of that move.
Oh, nice little spin there by Ava Menace. And through there on the side, on the inside lane, spins around the pack in its entirety. Getting a lot of help there by Stephanie Maney. Just, again, as you said earlier, just knocking the blockers out of the way just a bit. And hey, there's Honey Boo Boo with a star in hand and sneaking through the pack really lowly.
That's good timing. Oh, mm-hmm. It looks like at the end of that is Sniffy Go Free heading to the penalty box as well for illegal contact.
So 16 total, it looks like, for Bay Area on that one.
You see a replay there. I think this might be the spin.
Oh,
the hit to the inside of Ava Menace.
Always cuts off right when.
I know.
That's it. Camus taking on Beaver Mansbridge. And around the inside so quickly, that's Camus. Camus around again, now eligible to put points on the board. And then there you have the Bay Area line. Beaver Mansbridge, 2 blockers at the front and is finally able to shake them.
Yeah, we're seeing that Bay Area back line that they love to do, but this time with a front point.
Mm-hmm. So Camus was able to put 3 on that time, able to get past 3 blockers.
So you can see in that replay there, oh, Camus just around the inside, mm-hmm. drops that outside shoulder so that Brawlin' Angel just kind of misses and goes mm-hmm. right to the inside lane. So important to have that awareness
right.
in such an impressive instance where you can drop that shoulder just to get around.
So Leg Cite on the jammer line for Bay Area, and that scarce attack for Lomme. Bay Area really likes to recycle way back to the back here.
Looks like Garce dropped the helmet cover.
And it's trying to.
And Stephanie Maney
they're not,
says, no thanks.
They're guarding. There. Okay, she's able to reach through. So Lexite, meanwhile, picks up lead jammer for Bay Area. So we do have Garst Attack with us right now as she was able to reach through there. But Bay Area doing a good job of.
Yeah, we're seeing that three again. We're seeing Stephanie Maney consistently in front of that three. So that is the harder that Garst pushes, the stronger that wall gets.
Yep.
And then Legs able to come right around and take advantage of it. It's really difficult because the only real way to counter it is for your offense to pick off that front person or to be able to wrap around.
Like that. You saw her wrap around. It was a nice wrap around, but unfortunately the Bay Area blocker was able to come to find a way back in front again. It did pick up a penalty, by the way, for that movement, but... So Legs, meanwhile, getting bumped out over turn number two, is recycled back almost to the pivot line, past the pivot line here.
Looks like that was red card picking up a forearms penalty.
So Garst Attack did make it out of the pack on the initial, was not able to make it back around. So 12 points total for Bay Area on that.
Yeah, and that's going to bring us to Bay Area 95. Lomme 42. We're seeing the replay there. Legs pushing against that front two. Swiping the hips.
Yeah.
And then out of play. And we'll have an official timeout.
Legs is just so powerful. She's so powerful person. So, yeah, as you said, 95-42 in favor of Bay Area. We're just at 3 minutes left in the first half.
See, you've got your jammer stats there, so you have all the information we have. Lexite with 18, Eva Menes with 32, Red Card with 0, Beaver Mansbridge with 18, Kate Silver with 15. And then for Lomme, we have 8 points for Honey Boo Boo, 24 points for Garst Attack, Minimois with 3, Tajinator with 1, and Kimas with 10.
So, yeah, we're on an official timeout here, so I think we're just clarifying a few things while we wait. So at the end of that last jam, I'm sorry, it looks like Garst Attack has reported.
After assessing the drop star from the Lomme jammer in the previous jam, we have determined that a penalty should be issued. The star was retrieved, but not just by reaching down to pick it up. The jammer actually passed skaters while in a down position, so we are issuing a misconduct penalty for assuming an unblockable position.
Interesting. Okay.
Because she had to go down.
She had to go down and reach through
them to pick it up.
So, yeah. So.
And, yeah, you can't hit a down skater, so there's no way to counter that.
There's no way to block that person. Yeah, so we'll start with a power start. Interesting. I thought we were just clarifying some things, but we were actually...
I mean, we were clarifying some things.
Rethinking some of the...
Yeah.
But it was an interesting situation. I mean, that's why I love tournaments. You always see weird stuff.
Yes. Sometimes you see skaters crawl under other skaters.
Mm-hmm. You do. So Kate Silver taking the line on this power start. And, you know, Barry did do the run back that they do when they have a power start, but... Lomme was able to kind of hang on, but that is a forearm issued to Kate Silver, and now that will release Garst Attack out of the box. Bay Area is going to make sure Garst starts back farther than the jammer line, almost to the apex here.
Braun Angel with such a nice hit to the outside and run back.
So Garst Attack now back almost... Two turn three coming back in. Kate, nice job. Kate Silver's penalty is over. So Kate Silver will be re-entering the pack here. And wow, just a big, oh, a nice move to the outside there by Kate Silver. So there was just a big pile of bodies here at turn number four, actually. We hadn't even made it to the jammer line. And Kate Silver found that open outside lane. Does pick up lead for Bay Area. No, does not pick up lead. I'm sorry. Because she had a penalty. Apologize. But is now putting points on the board, which is the important thing. Garsh Attack has to pick up lead here to stop this.
Well, which cannot happen because she took the helmet cover off.
Oh, my gosh. You are so right. Thank you for correcting me on
but
that.
But I think
yes.
that was, I think that might have been a confused yes. moment because it had been so long and because Kate Silver had already
already
had that
gotten
first
out.
Yeah.
And, you know, yes, you're absolutely right. You removed the helmet cover. Lead is gone. So we're only got about 10 seconds left in the jam. But Kate Silver, meanwhile, just calmly putting more and more points on the board. So far, eight. We'll pick up a few more here on this last pass, three additional points. So great job by Bay Area, just kind of keeping it calm and collected.
You can see Kate Silver in that replay on the outside, turns the hips, has a second one as well, hops, and recovers from that slip up. Look at
this. Beautiful.
I mean, beautiful.
Beautiful. Skates completely in line.
My knees don't do that. They didn't when I skated, but they still definitely don't now.
So Honey Boo Boo gets caught up in a bunch of bodies there, and wow, that is Eva Menace picks up a penalty. And oh, I'm sorry. So Honey Boo Boo gets out of the pack but does not pass everybody upright and in bounds. So it'll be a pass no penalty. It will be no lead. We'll run the full jam.
Looks like that was a misconduct penalty for Eva Menace.
Interesting. Okay. So Honey Boo Boo trying to get through the pack and does again for that scoring pass. That's four. Now here's Eva Menace back on the track now. On the inside, dancing around and makes it out of the pack. Wow, so fast.
Well, and Steph Maney and Red Card both doing turns in the penalty box there. So Bay Area starting to get a little more intense. I mean, I guess we're seeing it from both teams, especially as they get closer to the end of the half. You're going to see that increase in penalties.
Rollin Angel with a nice hip check there and reset. Honey Boo Boo trying to find an opening, but Bay Area is just closed down. And so Ava's having to work around, too.
And Harley Quinn with that excellent, excellent, closed the only hole that was available to Eva, then also hit out a little, and then just a gentle rollback.
The entire pack is just a mob of people here at turn number one, and now we do have Honey Boo Boo getting recycled back.
I wonder how much of this game has been played in this first, like literally this first quarter.
You would think the floor would be lower here because of so much play
like
right
I
here.
I feel like some games it's pretty even or you're seeing action around. This game in particular, this first half, has felt like it was happening in 30 feet.
Between the jammer and the pit line, really. So we are now moving into halftime. Just to recap, Bay Area at 110, Lomme at 50. So I'm always interested to see what adjustments are made over halftime.
Absolutely. And penalties, they've gotten a little better. We can see a replay there. There's that hit to the inside. And
then,
look
yes.
at that.
Wonderful.
I feel like we don't talk enough about that kind of
yes.
offense. The offense that says, you're not hitting my jammer right now, but I'm going to make it so that you can't pull her all the way back.
Right. Yeah. The recycle, stopping the recycle is so important. So important.
You see the penalty board there. We have Bay Area with 18 total. Lomme with 20 total, so pretty evenly matched penalty-wise. Handful of skaters with four. We have Stephanie Maney there with four, Stevie Gaufrey, and Deck Detrice all with four penalties. So not intense, but something to keep your eye on for sure.
Something to be aware of.
We talked about at halftime.
Yes. All right. So I'm Ruby Longstocking.
I'm Sissy Splasek.
And we'll see you after halftime. Welcome back. This has been exciting. This is a game between Bay Area Derby All-Stars and Lomme Roller Girls, the Bad Bunnies.
Yes, and we are a little mesmerized here in venue because Lomme was just doing their pump-up song,
yes.
Chant.
It was lovely.
And it was really cute. And I wish I knew what they're saying, but I don't speak French.
I don't speak French either.
But it sounds beautiful.
But it was lovely.
We also had some questions on Twitter, and yes, there are tiny bunny paw prints on their jerseys.
That's true. The Bad Bunnies. That's what they are.
I'm Sissy Splasek.
I'm Rippy Longstocking.
And we're here for the second half of this game. Coming in, Bay Area in the lead with 110, Lomme with 50.
In the first half, I would just like to say, this is cliche, but the score does not represent what we've been seeing here. Just really great defensive moves out there. And as you said, the blockers able to switch between offense and defense really powerfully, make an impact for their jammer. So even though our jammers are
we've seen several 20-point jams.
Yes.
So
it's true.
A few of those. And
it was Bay Area. Bay Area at the very end of the first half started to pick up a little bit of steam. We were much closer throughout most of the first half in terms of points. So you'll see starting out the second half, that's Camus taking on Leg Cite. So again, if you're just tuning in, that's Camus out as, no, I'm sorry, picks up a track cut. So Camus in the red jerseys, Sloan in the red, and Bay Area, of course, in the black. Still open.
And Camus, that is her third trip to the penalty box so far this game.
So you can see she's a little disappointed in herself there.
Yeah, it's a rough way to come out of the half, but also when that first jam, you're so pumped up and you're so ready to put it all back out on the track. So, I mean, I feel like we see that.
So that pack stretched out the maximum length. Leg Cite finally slips past the last two blockers, picks up lead jammer.
Legs with that twirl around the outside.
Yeah. Such a powerful jammer is Legs. And then we do have a star pass for Lomme, and that would be to Princess Bombass. So Legs is going to call that off with 4 points on the board. I'm sorry, 8 points total, 4 points for that trip.
I think that was the first time we saw a pass to Princess Bombass.
I believe you are correct.
You see in the replay there. Oh, I should have explained it, but I was too busy watching it. Oh, and
yes.
Picking up that contract. But yeah, holding, freezing almost, going backwards, countering the line of that track, and just having that toe stop right out.
Right there. So it is Eva Menes on the line, taking on Garth Attack.
Yeah, I was putting a little of my own heritage on it.
Right, I think
with some Evas.
Yeah. So Eva, we have now made sure to note this on our notes here. Note on our notes.
Our notes are full of notes today.
Yes, they are. Garth Attack pushing against the front of the pack, but Bay Area again just hanging on her. She falls to her knees. And Bay Area's not going to let her get up without too much trouble there. I think that's Sniffy Gerf. Yeah, was trying to help out there with the jammer. Gets knocked out as well. Eva.
We're going to have a forearm penalty there. And I was trying to see who it was going to be. And it looks like it is Eva.
A low block. A low block, actually, was what sent Eva to the box there. Because that pileup, it's just unfortunate. You can get low blocks in there. So we now have the pack has shifted back to the jammer line again. This is something that we've seen this entire game is just not lead jammer picked up very quickly many times. Now that was a nice little push there by the Bad Lebowski, trying to get her jammer out, but the pack is not moving.
Yeah, I know. I feel like Bay Area heard the whole first half. I was talking about how they like to set up that back wall, and they said, all right, we'll see about that.
Yeah.
And so far this half, they have been doing mostly front walls.
But, oh, they just like, oh, nice. On the inside lane, a little hop and a skip, and Eva does pick up. No, gets out of the pack. There we go. On the initial pass, doesn't pick up any.
Game brought to you by Powerdyne. Powerdyne plates and skate products. Cutting edge designs, cutting edge performance with Powerdyne. You can see right there in your monitor, Steph Maney wedging in a nice offensive hit.
See? Just so nice.
Oh, but still not quite able to recover and bad closing that line.
So I think our lesson is don't skip leg day is what our lesson is today. Honey Boo Boo with the star for Lomme. Kate Silver wearing the star for Bay Area. And Kate Silver bounces around onside, picks up lead jammer. Star cover in hand for Honey Boo Boo. But again, Bay Area able to, well, knock out the jammer, but also keep those two separated, the pivot and the jammer.
Tajanator picking up a destruction penalty.
Kate Silver on the end. Little jump there. Manages to stay in bounds and picks up four.
Kate Silver showing us who owns those edges.
Yeah, really. So Honey Boo Boo getting knocked around in there. Kate Silver now will pick up another penalty, a back block penalty. This will be a power jam for Honey Boo Boo. And Honey Boo Boo is just stuck in between everybody. There.
Yeah, Honey Boo Boo so far with 16 points this game, so second highest scorer for her team. But this jam really struggling with that Bay line and Bay Area line, excuse me.
Yeah. And a penalty there also. Looks like a low block, I think, was being assessed there for Honey Boo Boo. So jammer penalties.
Jammer penalties. Well, the low block is such a frustrating. I mean, they're all frustrating penalties, but
low block.
Usually, it's because you've been hit.
Yeah,
and so
on the ground somehow.
It's just adding insult to injury.
Yes. So 4 points on the board for Kate Silver. A total of 8 so far. Lomme has yet to put any points on the board. This jam. Nice spin. Nice spin by Kate Silver. Picks up another four.
Kate Silver taking advantage of those Lomme blockers in the box. Here you can see to the inside with the hip.
Look.
Jumps almost just straight up. Let's the blocker move past her and then continues.
Nice move. So that's like Cite off the jammer line. And Camos, yes. No, they've got... I'm looking at Camos here, but I think the scoreboard is incorrect, yes. Like Cite out of the pack, picks up a lead jammer. Quick 4 points there.
Mini Moi sitting
there.
Currently in the penalty box as
There's
the Camos. Pivot, which is important to know when a jammer takes off that helmet cover.
Yes. Now Camos unable to put any points on the board.
All right, we are at Bay Area 138. Lomme with 50. Bay Area on quite the scoring run.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to see that replay there. Offense push to the inside, open that big line for legs. And 22
nice
minutes
move.
And 22 seconds left to go in this game.
And we all have a quick timeout here.
So we have an official timeout.
Yeah.
Our team timeout for Lomme. There you can see.
Oh, wow, what a nice landing.
Apex jump to the inside.
It's on 1 foot. I'm just landing on 1 foot. That's just
I feel like we haven't seen as many apex jumps this tournament. Like a lot more spins, a lot more jukes. I don't know. Where is the jump? Let me see it, jammers.
I've seen some what I call casual apex jumps, yes. Which are just like the little skip. I'm going to just...
Like I'm just having a nice day and I want everyone to know it.
I'm just going to skip over this little corner, no big deal. And that rolling whistle tells us that we're getting ready to go. Okay, we still have that on the board, but it's 138 to 50, 22 minutes and 19 seconds left in the second half of this contest between Bay Area Derby All-Stars and Lomme Roller Girls Bad Bunnies.
Bad Bunnies.
Bad Bunnies. Garce Attack taking on Eva Menes. And Eva Menes on the inside picks up lead.
So many leads happening by the jammer's sideways hits.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like people have gotten so good at switching their direction.
So Garce Attack, nice reach around the entire pack, passes that star. And I want to say that's Minimoys. Yeah, that's correct.
And that was Pinky Bruiser, number 380, with that lovely run back.
Minimoys picked up the star, but unable to get back around the track to pick up any points. So 142 to 50 in favor of Bay Area.
You can see Eva right there, sideways, nice. And is able to see that hit coming in. Actually elevated just a little bit in order to get over those hips, miss the hip, and pick up lead.
Legsite around the inside, spinning and spinning. And out of play, and they have to let her go, and there is a penalty assessed again to the pivot. That is Minimoys, and Honey Boo Boo has got the star in hand for Lomme.
I know, it's like that was Minimoys' fifth penalty. So
that's not good. Minimoys has been playing that pivot position, an important position. 4 points on the board for Legsite.
And is joined by Sniffy Gofrey, who is also picking up the fifth.
Honey Boo Boo picks up a forearm penalty. So this is a power jam for Legs. Oh. Oh, okay. Excuse my frustrated. No, it is. Okay.
Yes.
We have seen people send Minimoys to the box and then rescind that and then re-add it, so now...
Well, and unfortunately, that was the sixth penalty, a cut track, I believe, because
yes.
Minimoys entered the pack at the back from the box. Or possibly was released, left early. Let's see.
Yeah. Not sure what exactly happened, because it looked like she was motioned back to the track, but then motioned back to the penalty box. So.
Yeah, but definitely did pick up a sixth as a cut track for yes. that incident.
So, unfortunately, that's not great news for Lomme. But Legs, on the other hand, just decides to put 12 points on the board.
Legs powered through those 12 points.
Yes. And Legs, again, just not really... Oh, no, another forearm. That is seven. No, I'm sorry. That's not seven. Good. That was Honey Boo Boo, so that will be a jammer. That Honey Boo Boo is serving as a jammer right now, has the jammer cap in hand, will serve this penalty as a jammer.
And that is Honey Boo Boo's fifth penalty. And then, of course, we also have Sniffy Gofrey on five, and Minimoys on six. All right, looks like we have an official timeout. So we're going to see Legs there all the way to the line, but able to balance. And then just, I've been calling it pushing the football truck. Like when you see in football
yes.
training where they're having to push that sled, like that's what we're seeing.
Yes.
That's what we saw from Legs
that
there.
Is absolutely. And one of the advantages of being tall is when you move your hips out of the way, you've got that balance, that ballast to sort of balance you. So she could really... move those hips out of the way for the blocker to just sort of swoop in and, yeah. you know.
Well, and as the blocker, you want to keep being mobile, but sometimes you're strongest if you can stabilize instead.
Right.
And so you really just have to dig into those toe stops and let them sled push you. Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, she's good at both maneuvering out of the way and also just going for it and pushing that truck.
Yeah.
Pushing that truck forward.
It's well, very, I feel like
talented.
We're watching Two-A-Days.
Just the energy that it's out here is insane to me.
Take this moment to say a few thank yous from the WFTDA. We'd like to thank Derby City Skates, Strong Athletic, Texas Roller Girls, Derby Girl Designs, Chicks and Bulls, Rydell, Radar Wheels, Powerdyne, and RollerCon. Looks like they are conferring
right.
with the captains right now.
It might be some clarification of what was happening there with Minimoys.
Yes, with that sixth, with that cut track.
Yeah. Just making sure everybody's on the same page.
And it does look like Minimoy is returning to the penalty box.
And do you remember Honey Boo Boo picked up that penalty right at the end, so almost a full 30 seconds. In the penalty box for this power start for Bay Area.
Lomme Pivot Red 237 has been issued a penalty box violation, and they have also fouled out. We are providing a box substitute.
Okay, so it was the cut track and the penalty box violation, so that brought her to seven. That is unfortunate for Lomme.
That is unfortunate. I mean, obviously there was some confusion there. We were confused. Mm-hmm. Seeing what looked to be a little bit of a questionable leave of the box and enter the track on top of a cut track.
Right.
So
Lomme has substituted in a skater as pivot. So now we have the jammer and the pivot for Lomme in there in the box. Meanwhile, Bay Area has chosen to field Eva Menace as their jammer for this power start. And there's the run back that we have become so accustomed to.
Really like clockwork.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I love that it's consistent, but also they're working together. Their timing of that run and return is so crisp.
Yes, it is very nice looking. So Eva, out of the pack fairly quickly, through like so fast. Everybody's still in the box.
And with a very, very smart call.
Yeah.
Very smart call to be able to keep the pivot and the jammer.
Yes. They're not even standing, right? They're not even standing.
You see Eva splits that line. She saw that they were both turned in towards her, and she had those two hips that she could use to her advantage to just split right through the two. A little bit of confusion. Looks like Lomme attempted to field the jammer and then had to bring her back out.
Yeah.
That Honey Boo Boo could sit.
Yes, we didn't even. They're standing. Okay, both jammer and pivot for Lomme are standing in the penalty box. Meanwhile, Beaver Mansbridge with the star for Bay Area is out of the pack and now picks up lead. Now, I was getting ready to say everyone's released, but that's Sniffy Griffer in the box now.
Yeah, looks like that was an out of play. For Sniffy.
So Honey Boo Boo now back again for the tripod, trying to get a leg in there. It does, in fact, get a leg in there. Not much else, just the one. And meanwhile, that is Princess Bombass that had taken the pivot stripe and is now blocking. And looks like Honey Boo Boo's looking for the pivot. But Princess Bombass unable to get back right now.
Yeah, is looking so far ahead, but when that pivot is tied into that action at the front of the pack, it's definitely tricky.
You can't really let go of that pressure. So Honey Boo Boo back in to the track around the pivot line. We just keep moving up a little bit and recycling and moving up a little bit and recycling. So we really are still between the jammer line and the pivot line.
I'm getting tired watching this jam.
It is all happened right there. So we did have a star pass there right at the very end to Princess Bombass, as Bombass unable to even really get out of the pack good before the jam was called. It was 4 points for Bay Area on that one.
All right, you can see that run at the front. Beaver Mainsbridge pushing. Beats one, has to return to stay in play, and right around the second. It's such a difficult decision as a pivot because you know you need to go back and help your jammer relieve your jammer. But if you are the key pin that's yes. holding that opposing jammer at the front of the pack, you have to make right. that decision.
And so lead jammer goes to Camus. And now Legs also out of the pack. Legs, CTA wearing the star for Bay Area. Camus. See, here's the bench. Give the call off motion and does so.
Pinky Bruiser picking up a destruction. And you can see in the replay, right on that outside line, toe stop. And then just such a huge hit, but holds it. Catches backwards
so nice.
On the toes. The most precise way before turning back.
Eva Menace taking on Garza Tack. So Eva pushed into the infield. Thinks about coming in, but takes herself back out of there. Wow, just look at that pushing with Garce on the front of that shot. Just not moving. It's just sort of stopped there at the pivot line.
And in the back, Ava Menace is locked down,
yeah.
still really working those edges, trying to see if she can take the back all the way to the right, all the way to the left. Find some sort of purchase there.
Looks like a forearm will be assessed for Garza Attack. Right as, so Pinky Bruiser popped up out of the penalty box, went straight for that tripod, trying to break out the jammer, but instead we have a penalty for Garz.
Joined by Bad Lebowski with a multiplayer penalty. And Garz, that's only her second penalty so far. So very light yeah. penalty-wise. And very consistent jamming.
So even Menace on that one picked up four, decided to call this off on a power start here.
So we're seeing Eva to the outside, gets a little nice. Tap there from Boone Villain. A little, you're doing great, bud, which always feels nice to hear.
Yeah.
A little
Go
encouragement.
Friend.
Yeah.
Go forth, friend.
I believe.
Yes. So for this power start, Kate Silver wearing the star out almost immediately off the jammer line with only two blockers there to try to stop her. Not doing a great job. Didn't stop her, let's say.
Yeah, and the clean timing of Kate hitting the back of the pack at the exact same time that Bay Area ran back.
Right.
Just instantly doubling that distance.
Well, oh no. And a back block is now assessed to Garza Attack. I'm sorry, cut track. A penalty.
The curse of the announcer. As soon
yes.
as you say they are light in penalties, I apologize for whatever I put into the universe.
You should only use your powers for good.
I know.
Why
I try.
Why?
Speaking of penalties, that is number 42, esteemed Bun Bun, picking up a direction.
So Lomme had Kate Silver sort of locked up there, so Kate Silver calls it, but not before putting 8 points on the board.
Putting on a sweet 8 points, bringing it Bay Area 178, Lomme 52, and 12 minutes left to go in this game.
I'm just watching all of these people perform and just the lockdown and the kind of strength. I'm just amazed that they're making me tired and I'm sitting up here.
I know. I feel like we always talk about the leg strength, and really so much of this is the core. Like, to be able to stabilize and be so mobile and so agile at the same time.
So, yeah, that's Lexite with a star for Bay Area. So Garcetak has been released from the penalty box, is engaging with Bay Area here, the Bay Area defense, which we've seen. This is that wall again with the legs, the two legs in front. And it has been very effective for all of the jammers for Lomme.
Pat Lebowski with another destruction.
Oh, legs. From the right to the left, moving across the track. Knocks off a couple of blockers on the way out, picks up four.
Yeah, and I was watching esteemed Bun Bun with that dart to the outside to play a little O, but looked like picked up a penalty for it. So it seemed very effective, but it's unfortunate. And bringing them to five with that direction.
So the Bad Lebowski now wearing the pivot star for Lomme, but now picks up a penalty. And, oh, looks like legs is just doing a little positional here. No, there's the shoulder. On to Garce. They both come in. And a back block assessed to legs Cite. So.
Yeah, that is unlucky for sure. Legs playing a little of that jammer D, noticing that they had players sitting in the box, and might as well delay that a little bit, stretch that out, get those skaters back on, and picking up that back line.
Yeah, just really unfortunate. Because it was a good strategy. So Garcetak is able to put some points on the board for Lomme.
Yeah, Garcetak with it.
So, yeah.
They were waiting to see an update. 11,
yeah,
there it is.
Mm-hmm.
11 points for Garcetak. That was a huge jam for Garce and for Lomme.
The back and forth bodies in the penalty box certainly is one of the stories of the second half here.
Oh, yeah. I think in that replay we were seeing that back block.
Oh, look. She said it as she came up.
We have a team timeout for Bay Area, which, of course, smart call.
Mm-hmm.
Lomme with that 8-point run, 11-point run, excuse me. Good time to reset, try to break some of that momentum. You're seeing in that replay, Garce to the outside, and really no able to catch.
Once she found that lane, she was through. It was,
you know, and if you're using the track correctly, which of course the skaters at this level are all using the track correctly, but when you do that outside run, especially at the corner, you have such a beautiful straight line to cut right to the apex of the other turn. Bay Area with 190, Lomme with 63, and just under 10 minutes left to go in this game.
So legs standing in the box as we begin this jam power start for Honey Boo Boo wearing the star for Lomme. Honey Boo Boo able to battle through all of the bodies there. Star off the head of legs. Still holding it, though. It looks like the star in hand. Honey Boo Boo is back around and into that defense from Bay Area.
You're seeing the three there, Stephanie Maney with the bridge, but still able to absorb and support that pack. Mm-hmm. She needs to. And Lomme with a lot of work at the front of the pack to knock legs out and bring back.
I don't even want to say this, but I'm going to. There's nobody in the penalty box.
Why? Why would you talk about it?
Why would I say that? Why would I say that out loud? Because someone to the penalty box.
Oh, Grim Reba.
Grim Reba.
Apologies. That direction.
You know, I didn't want to say it, but I did.
We just want the officials to have company
over
there.
And I apologize. So Honey Boo Boo did make it out of the pack, is lead jammer for Lomme.
And maybe pulling herself out of that, that hole.
Oh, the battering.
so frustrating when you finally break out of that and then
getting hit, recycled
back.
So the star pass has been made for on Bay Area. I'm sorry, didn't mean to be confusing there. Stephanie Maney now with the star, unable to pick up any points on that pass. Three additional points. Four, Honey Boo Boo.
We have an official timeout. And it looks like an official review. We're going to see that Honey Boo Boo hitting the back of the pack there and stepping around.
Yeah. Again, sorry about sound effects, but sometimes they just have to happen. It's the only way to truly describe.
Official review for Bay Area, so we're clear. This game brought to you by S1 Helmets, S1 Life Revisor Helmet, next level protection from S1 Helmets.
So certainly we will hear from our skating officials here to let us know what this official review is specifically about.
The WFTA's Diversity and Inclusion Committee is looking to expand its members. Special consideration will be given to those applicants from underrepresented groups. Find out more and apply at resources.wftda.com. We're still chatting out there. Bay Area's dancing a little.
It's a good way to keep warm.
It's a good way to keep warm.
Loosen up a little.
Shake off some nerves. And
I feel like Lomme. Okay.
This is Bay Area's second half official review. Bay Area is requesting an expulsion to Lomme jammer number 2 on their first scoring pass at turn 1.
Okay.
Interesting. Okay. They're looking to have an expulsion for Honey Boo Boo. That would have 2 players down, one with the 7 penalties. And one of the jammer, we might be able to get a little more information about why the expulsion call here when we hear back from our officials.
Yeah, I feel like I could speculate a little, but not 100% sure on what incident they would be looking for that expulsion for. We can look at Lomme's penalties really quick. We have 3 skaters with 5 and 1 with 6. And then, of course, we had number 237, that was Minnie Wong, who was expelled or ejected earlier.
Right.
So that freeness we had at the start of the half, you know, of 20.
After review, the officials have confirmed that the contact by Lomme jammer was legal. There will be no expulsion nor penalty, and Bay Area will not retain the review.
Okay, interesting.
Okay.
I mean, again, the officials are right there. They've got the eyes on the action at all times.
Yeah. Well, and it's, you know, to go asking for the penalty is one thing. Asking for the expulsion
yeah,
is definitely the next step.
Right. Camus out there with the star for Lomme. And that, of course, is Eva Menace with the star for Bay Area. So that was Brawlin' Angel that picked up multiplayer block. That's a pivot, unfortunately, for Bay Area. But out as lead jammer is Camus. Eva Menace also out of the pack now. Camus through the pack and calling it. Unable to put up the full 4, but 3 points.
Picks up 3.
That's right.
Yeah, and had that jump around backwards, that
right.
180 to grab that last 3rd point. You can see on the inside onto the toe stops. And picks up that lead. So clean.
Mm-hmm.
Bay Area with 190. Lomme with 73. And just over 7 minutes left to go in this game.
Garce attack back on the line with Beaver Mansbridge. Okay, so that was Brawlin' Angel cleared from the box. And so now we have all the bodies on the track. Garce attack just unable to find any room at all. Bay Area has been able to really shut down Garce attack and other jammers as well with that defensive stance there. The brace not even really needing to brace, just kind of waiting there in anticipation. Meanwhile, Beaver Mansbridge at the front, also struggling with the Lomme defense.
Yeah, sometimes it's nice when you have that flexibility for the brace to absorb if they need to, or support if they need to, or be in such a perfect position to just kind of gently bridge the packs together and yes. communicate, which is helpful.
So Pinky Bruiser working all over the Bay Area defense. Cannot get a purchase on that. I'm just so impressed with the defense here. I mean, Pinky Bruiser is just all in there, and Bay Area is not having it. And so forearm will be assessed to Esteem Bun Bun.
And that is Esteem Bun Bun's sixth penalty.
I'm watching Bay Area. They'll scooch the jammer to one of the lines and then just gently bump with a hip and a hip and a hip until they can get the jammer out. Now, want to point out, beautiful star pass there. Just very quick, very snap. Four, Garce attack. Two, Princess Bombass.
Tajander picked up a penalty there.
So, Beaver, I just want to point out, we went from the jammer line to just past turn one. That whole jam was taking place between the jammer line and just a little past, not quite to the apex, turn one. That was the whole jam. We didn't move but that far.
And it was beautiful. You could see the replay there, the strong three. And then having that helmet cover, seeing the tripod, able to step around it to the inside and rush right past.
Look, CJ with the star for Bay Area. That's Honey Boo Boo with the star for Lomme. And, yeah, Lomme picks up lead. That's Honey Boo Boo with the star picking up lead. And Leg Cite also out of the pack. A little spin move there for Honey Boo Boo. Looks to the bench to see if she's call off. That's Miss Miyagi there on the sidelines trying to give advice. And so Honey Boo Boo finally calls that.
Steph Manny with two in a row to just shut down that inside line and return. You're seeing legs working to the outside, hitting that two, and then taking advantage of it. If you're going to keep them busy, I'll mm-hmm. just go this way.
Yes, it works. That's a good strategy. So that's Eva Menace on the line, taking on Camus. Camus, oh, thought that whistle was for lead, but it was for a forearm.
Yeah, I wonder, I saw Stephanie Maney hop a little bit out of bounds, so I'm wondering if that was that incident.
So Eva Menace picking up lead jammer for Bay Area will come into the pack.
It's Pinky Bruiser 380 with a cut track on that one.
And Eva Menace out of the pack and decides to call it, icing those folks in the box.
Yeah, and joined by Harlequin right at the end for a low block.
So, power start, track advantage. Bay Area decides to field Kate Silver for this one.
Yeah, we're seeing the replay there. Yeah, and I think it happened behind us where we could see on the other side. But, yeah, Steph Maney with that getting hit with the mm-hmm. up and out.
And, again, that signature move of the drawback. Oh, sorry. I don't know if you could see that on your camera or not, but that was
stay with
our
me.
Friends were going to tell the Grim Reaver what where to be on the track there. No problem. They're doing a great job, and it works really well. Camus trying to hand off the star, does, but Bay Area, aware of what's happening, knocks the pivot into the infield. Princess Bombass now has the star, so that's the pivot, number 712, does have the star in hand. One blocker to beat, makes it out of the pack on the initial.
Looks like Harley Quinn returning to the penalty box, this time for a cut track for that action here on the outside.
So Kate Silver picking up 10 points on that pair of trips.
All right, we're going to see the start of that jam like we talked about. Kate Silver forward, Bay Area back.
We get the, oh, you missed the shirt pull.
Imagine a beautiful little assist from your teammate to get in line.
Every once in a while, you need a little help from your friends.
You really do. Who doesn't?
Yes. Garcetak back on the line for Lomme. And that is Leg Cite out of the pack, picking up lead jammer. So star in hand for Garce. Looking for the pivot, but the pivot is doing some work way up front. And there we have the drift back. Ah, oh, looking for the star. So Bay Area is just so aware of where the star is at all times. It's just so, it's miraculous.
Well, and Legs was not having it on that pack.
Mm-hmm.
Knocked Snippy Go Free all the way into the ref lane to clear the lane for herself.
Again, agile and also really strong.
Looks like the clock is running down on us.
Yes.
That happened suddenly, it feels
it
like.
It does.
We were just in 5 minutes.
We're very excited about this game. Again, the score doesn't tell you what's happening out here. A few unfortunate penalty calls for Lomme. But, man, just a lot of power out there. You look at Bay Area separate those two. That is just amazing. That is amazing to me. They are literally separating with their shoulders, the two, the jammer and the pivot.
Yeah, just...
Oh, Legs is going to tumble, but get back up, maybe.
And Lomme with the smart reset in front to be in the right position to be able to catch.
So, our view is a little obscured here. It looks like Legs thought maybe there was a cut. And just to make sure, hey, you know, you're sitting comfortably, might as well go back and just to make sure. But it is four additional points there for Legs, CTA. The jam clock at 10 seconds. Period clock at zero.
Green Reaper heading to the box at the very end of that. And we have an unofficial score of Bay Area 220, Lomme 79. If you're interested in learning more about Derby Without Borders, it's our charity project dedicated to removing barriers to accessibility in the sport of roller derby. See how you can get involved at derbywithoutborders.org. In that replay, we're seeing Legs. Just a little around the outside.
I mean, such a powerful skater. So we're still looking at the unofficial here. Do have to wait, of course, in case someone wants to call something. But I think, Sissy, a lot of some of the story of this particular game. Lomme absolutely came out with a lot of power, but then had some unfortunate penalty situations, a couple of jammer penalties in a row. What do you think about? What is your take on this story?
Yeah, I mean, I think penalties were a story. They felt a little farther apart in penalty disparity than reading the scores. Mm-hmm. So, like, looking at it, we see that Bay Area had 31 total at the end of the game, whereas Lomme had 47. Right. That's not, I mean, that's a difference, but it's not a huge difference. I do think you're right that it's a jammer. We're seeing those jammer penalties, and I think the timing of the penalties. So if you have one penalty at a time, that's not that big a deal. But if your three penalties are happening at the same time that they're racking up and having those high-scoring jams, that's where you're going to see that disparity.
Yes.
You can see there, we, of course, had the foul out from number 237, Minimois. And then we also had two other skaters that finished at 5, one at 4, and two at 6. So, you know, more than you would like to see.
Right.
And then Bay Area, of course, esteemed Bun Bun, only or with 6 as the most penalty heavy. And then we had a smattering there, Stephanie Maney with 4, red card with 4, and number 538, Kate Silver with 4 as a jammer.
But, yeah, I think the jammer penalties, as you said, were, and when Lomme had a jammer penalty, sometimes it was two jammer penalties in a row for the same person. And so I think that was something that put a damper on their motivation and their morale, I guess.
Yeah, I think Lomme adapted really well. Mm-hmm. I think they seemed to change, especially first to second half. It seemed like they came out, they were very flexible, and they were, you could see that they were modifying their play to better counter Bay Area.
Right.
I think Bay Area's precision just pushed past that.
They They're on task with one another. Yes, yeah. Yes.
All right, this has been an amazing game.
It's been really great game to
watch. And we have our friends down at the sideline.
Ready to go.
Ready for an interview.
Revolution here down on the track. I'm with Leg Sate and Kate Silver. How y'all feeling?
Great. Seems amazing.
Yeah. So, Kate, you're normally on this side of the microphone. Now you're on this side of the microphone. Tell me, you know, I feel like you've had a really, a good year. How's the postseason feel rolling?
It feels really good. You know, we came to this tournament really ready to play. We were preparing, you know, for Atlanta, who's just like such a solid team and so great. And going against the Bad Bunnies, like, it was like awesome. They're such a tough team. They're like super strong. They've got like all this fight in them. It's amazing.
Yeah, so I noticed you're kind of doing a new strategy where you roll back at the jam start. Were you nervous that that wouldn't be received well here or that it wouldn't work? And how do you feel like it went?
Pretty fine.
I think it was great. Worked well.
Worked well.
Yeah.
Awesome. So what's your secret that brought you here to your first postseason on skates?
Make sure to thread your eyebrows every month.
Every month.
Yeah.
Okay.
At least once a month. And then, like, keep them up if you can't go to the salon. You know, just do that.
All right. My secret is to really invest in my league and make sure our league is strong and the upcoming skaters are strong and my team is strong. And I pluck my own eyebrows.
I don't do anything to my eyebrows now. I feel very eyebrow focused. And one more thing. I was told to ask you about your hot sauce consumption.
Tapatio.
We're doing that. You know, Steffi hooked me up. Kids hot sauce in her bag. The whole house is using it. It's part of what Legs is talking about. Share everything with the team. Leave it all. Do it all for the team.
Thank you both. Have a wonderful rest of your tournament. Thanks so much for talking to me.
Thank you. Sober.